This is a queue waiting to get into the Reina Sofia, where Picasso's picture Guernica is. What you don't realise, of course, is that once you get through the door, you turn left, and there's one of these snake queues. So if you were at the back of this queue here, it's going to take you at least half an hour to get your ticket. Unless, and having queued in this thing for 20 minutes, I got to the front, and because I presented my passport, and because I was of a certain age, it was free. The Picasso Guernica is not available to see all the time. So it's now 4:30, and you cannot go and see the Guernica exhibition until 6:30. So I'm going to have a meander elsewhere and come back. This is the park, Teatro del Angel Caído. This looks beautiful. It's 5 minutes walk from the hotel. Very peaceful, lots of people here. Just relaxing, sitting in the shade. That wonderful blossom on that tree there, beautiful. In the middle of the park is this monument to King Alphonse the 12th. We take a little rowing boat out and have a meander around. And there are lots of activities. There's a brass or jazz band over there. And then just down here is a wizard, a magician, entertaining the kids. It's very good, I watched him. It's a lovely place.
Dile de qué color es el pañuelo.
Rojo.
Ahora gritáis, listos, antes ninguno.
Carmen, ponte aquí. ¿De qué color es el pañuelo, Carmen? Fuerte y alto. ¿Cómo? ¿Cómo?
Transparente.
¿Transparente? ¿Rojo? No digas
transparente. ¿Qué color es? Dice que te raspando una ala. Decía Carmen que era transparente.
Carmen. ¿Qué color es el pañuelo fuerte y alto?
Carmen.
No, estoy haciendo magia, Carmen. ¿De color rojo? No, a ver. ¿Cómo que naranja?
Esto es naranja. Carmen. A ver, ponte ahí.
Carmen, dímelo. ¿De qué color es fuerte y alto?
Carmen, hay que coger este pañuelo, mete la mano y tíale.
Es comparable.
A ver, cógetelo contra la otra mano, que no tienes mano ya. Cógete el rojo y acabamos. Mete la mano bien hasta adentro. Más, Carmen. Carmen, ¿qué es para hoy? Seguro que no lo ves. Carmen, mira a ver.
Y lo he dicho, acabamos.
¿Cómo? Que no. Carmen, vamos a ver, saca la mano. ¿Cómo podéis decir que no si hay un montón de pañuelos? A ver, ¿cómo dices que no? Carmen, ¿esto qué es? Pues entonces no me digas que no hay ninguno. Carmen, por favor. Venga, mete la mano, ya no te coges. Mira que sabes que hay algo dentro. Carmen, no mientas. ¿Hay algo dentro?
Salada, yo me estoy imaginando a Paula.
¿El qué? ¡Carmen! Vamos con más pañuelos. Mira, a ver, sácalo. Mira, a ver si está listo. Vamos a ver. ¿Cómo que no hay nada? ¿Dices que no hay nada? Vamos a ver. Carmen, hay que coger el rojo. Coge el rojo. No, todo. Toma. Mete la mano a ver si hay alguno.
Es de los que tiene, ¿eh? Falta el rojo.
Carmen, vamos a ver, hay que coger el rojo. Vamos a ver. Carmen, mira, la última prueba. Vamos a meter todos los pañuelos dentro, Carmen. A ver, mételos dentro todos, que hay muchos. Todos los que hay, Carmen. Es un lío. Fíjate cómo está de pañuelos el saco.
It's undergoing restoration. Now you see on this is King Alphonse the 12th sitting on his horse. It's got this wonderful colonnade all the way around. These nice bright light and shadows. The boats are very popular. There's a queue of about 50 people all waiting to get a rowing boat. On my left, he's got a didgeridoo made out of cardboard rolls. Unfortunately, he's just stopped playing it. This is obviously the glass palace, large greenhouse. Unfortunately, it's got nothing inside it. Interesting gargoyles it's got. Terrapin in this pond. Camera shy. Well, you cannot take photos of Guernica, but this is some of Dali's work, which is equally as bizarre. If not more so. This is one by John Morrow called Man with a Pipe. I'm afraid I just don't see it at all. And in the middle of the art gallery there is this courtyard. And these pollarded trees are sort of, could almost be an exhibit. A stark black outline against the stone of the building and the bright blue sky. me I should take a copy and print it. Probably entitle it Man's Inhumanity to Trees, Madrid, 2017. These are the queues in the evening. It's 7:20. It's absolutely enormous. It's far better to order your tickets online. Because you've got this big queue here, and once you get inside, you've got one of these snake queues that you get at most fun parks. So the queue is longer than they think it is. I mean, some of these people are going to be waiting for, well, they're not going to get in. Plaza Mayor, 9:00 at night, lots of eating places, kids firing these things up in the air, a little propeller on. It's a busy, busy place. In fact, the whole place is busy, every street is packed full of people. If you turn off the main street into the little avenues, you find all kinds of little quiet places where the locals are gathering. They all sit outside gossiping. And lots of people promenading, they're just out for the evening. Typical Spanish style.
This afternoon there will be the
ball. Well, this is the royal palace. Oh, king and queen don't live here anymore. They live elsewhere. And I think it's now a museum. Well, certainly you can go in and wander around. It's a pretty impressive building, and next door to it is a cathedral, which wasn't finished until the 1990s. That's one hell of a camera, that. They're dressed up in antique clothing. This is the other side of the Royal Palace. You have to pay to go in. There's a long, long queue to get in. this is the cathedral. It's relatively modern, 19th century. Huge queues waiting to get into the Royal Palace. It's Palm Sunday. Palm Sunday, so they're selling these woven fronds. These woven palms, that man there's got loads of them.
Tengo derecho de imagen. Tienes que pagar por grabarme.
And these people are selling, it looks like olives, olive branches, but palms. Many people are carrying them around. This is a cathedral. I'm going to have a look in there this afternoon. The Royal Palace is up there. So this is the coat of arms of Madrid. People trailing around it.
I couldn't hear her.
Depicting the forest,
crown on the top, tree, the animals, and the seven stars of the various constellations. There are some wonderful buildings. This is just one example. This is a 15th century building. It's the original city hall. Lots of little interesting side streets like this one here with this bell tower. If I just move around a little bit, there's another tower there. Strange structure. I have no idea what it is. Many beautiful trees, and then above them, the buildings are immaculate, they've all been cleaned. You see this sort of typical Eiffel type architecture. I think it's iron and glass. And this leads down to the Plaza Mayor, where we're going to have lunch. This girl has a pig. Nuts. Absolutely nuts. This lady here with this pig. This stone marks the centre of Spain. Every kilometre measurement in Spain is taken from here, which is on the pavement in this square. In the Puerto del Sol in Madrid, there is a building here. The Swedish flag with a piece of black material hanging on it because of the terrorist bombings 2 days ago in Stockholm. It's an absolutely bizarre thing to watch. You put money in there, watch. That little woman put some money in. There's a person sitting inside of it. Nuts. So this is the Plaza Mayor in the afternoon. This is King Philip III of Spain. Sitting on his horse, so he's holding behind that horse's head at the moment. And there he is with his ruff. Is there on that sign now, Plaza Mayor. I hold it steady enough. Beautiful blue skies, wonderful temperature. in the evening, like when I was here last night. It's even more busy. There we are, that's it. Well, after our tour, we are in La Bodegueria, down in the crypt, or our cellar, for our lunch, which will be tapas. And they've set aside 2 hours for this. So, be interesting to see what we get. Oh, here we are. This shop sells an amazing array of what looks like rock. Stunning. There's 2 sculptures at the Tortuga station. This is one of them. She is awake. So the baby's head with her eyes open. And this is one asleep, her eyes closed. There's a little lad just run across here and stuck his hand up that nose. This is the Palace de Sibylles, which I've come back to today because the lady's better. I think it used to be the post office. Right in front of it, not many buses gone. It's a fountain, Sibylles. See there. And there's an interesting sign in front of this building. On this little island, there's a model of the Gran Via, the main biggest street, shopping street in Madrid. And that is it for real. Again, the sun is in the wrong direction, but you've got nothing about it. It gives you the names of shops, or the fronts, the edifices as they call them here, when they were built, and who the designers were. It's an interesting thing. Nobody seems to notice it. I've just come across it. This is the Plaza del Callao. It's a sort of a cinema bit, like Piccadilly Circus. This is a communications facade. It's supposed to be by some well-known architect. The last rays of the sun touching the top of this building. Huge advertisement hoardings, absolutely enormous.
Oh,
SS8. And of course, like everywhere in Madrid at this time of night, it's busy, busy, busy.